Hagar was a single mother. She was abandoned by the family she belonged to. And there in the wilderness with her son, alone, with very little provision, she was wondering. She was questioning. Does anyone care? She's crying in the desert. She's lost in her despair. She thinks nobody loves her. Hagar thinks nobody's there. But God says, I will be a ring of fire around her, and I and the power of my presence will bring her to her knees, and I will lift her up again, for I'm the God who sees. I'm the God who sees. Speaks in gentle whispers, and he softly calls her name. She feels his arms enfold her as he holds her, and she'll never be the same. 'Cause I'm the God who never changes, and my promises are true. And when this world deserts you, this is what I'll do. And then there was another woman named Ruth. She was from the land of Moab, and she was met with grief and heartache. She was a widow, and she lived with her mother-in-law, who was also a widow. And now it was time to move on. But Ruth had never been to Bethlehem. She had never tasted of the house of bread. But now she had heard an inner invitation to come and taste and see. And so she vowed herself to her mother-in-law and said, where you go, I will go. Where you lie, I will lie. Where you die, I will die. And she begins a journey to the promised land. She's traveling through the desert, and she's leaving her despair. She's hoping for a future, praying God will lead her there. And he says, I will put a ring around your finger, and I will bless a child within your womb, and the Savior will born for you to free the world from sin, and he'll make all things new for you and love you back to life again. And then from Ruth, who gave birth to a son, Obed, who gave birth to a son, Jesse, who gave birth to a son named David. Now the same once shepherd boy, mighty warrior, anointed king, is alone, terrified, in the darkness. He's hiding in the desert.
Thank you.